Hello friends. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to make animation frame by frame. The changes we make in each frame in the scene are called frame by frame. This is suitable for complex images and animations that need to change every frame. I included a photo of a gun for this tutorial. You can import photos into the program from the File and Import section. I want to make the bullet firing frame by frame. For this, first, I select the frame by frame layer from the New Layer section. Here we have to choose whether we want to use a photo or a vector. I select the vector. I move the layer down by dragging it. The shape of this layer is slightly different from other layers, and inside it there is a vector layer. In this layer, I draw a bullet. I draw an ellipse with the shape tool and with the transform and curvature tools. I change the points so that the oval looks like a bullet. I set the color of the field for it. I also change the color of the edge a little. Using the origin tool, I place the center point of the bullet in the middle of the shape. I make the bullet smaller with the transform tool and put it in the right place. Now I click on the frame by frame layer and use the origin tool to place its center point at the beginning of the bullet. You can see that three options have been added at the top of the timeline. The first is new frame to add a new frame. The second one is for deleting frames, and the third one is for getting duplicates. Now select the frame by frame layer and click on the new frame button. You can see that a line is created in the timeline and the bullet is hidden in the scene. If I go back to frame 0, I can see the bullet again, and using the origin mark, I can determine the location of the bullet in the next frame. I go back to frame 1 and draw the shape of a bullet again. Now you can see that there are two bullets in two different frames. But in order to be more accurate, we use another method, so I delete the bullet in frame 1. I put the slider in 0 frame and take a duplicate from the bullet. By pressing the duplicate button, the slider automatically moves forward 1 frame and a copy of the bullet is created for us. Now we can easily move the bullet forward with the transform tool. You can see that there are two bullets in two frames for us, and the bullet has moved forward. The more we increase the distance between two bullets, the speed of the bullet increases. This number shows us the distance between the frames. By pressing the duplicate button, the slider moves forward 1 frame. So when I am in frame 1, I get another duplicate. The slider automatically goes to frame 2. I move the bullet forward with the transform tool. I repeat the same thing several times until the bullet leaves the scene. After finishing this work, you can see that the animation of the bullet movement is well created for us. I put the mouse on frame 12, hold the Alt button and right click until the animation ends up to frame 12. Now I will press the play button to see the result. We were able to create this animation using the frame by frame layer. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.